Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome back to the channel. In today's reveal video, I'm gonna be talking about The Last of Us. This is a PlayStation exclusive. It has been out since 2013, but I still want to warn for spoilers as I will be talking a little bit about the story. I am kind of thinking that most of you know the story by now, so I won't go into depth about it too much. I will just give my opinion on how I think the game is. But a little bit of story will be revealed, so if you haven't played this game yet, and you still want to play it spoiler-free, by the way, then I admire you, but most importantly, this will contain spoilers, so I would not suggest watching this video. So The Last of Us is a story-based game. It sets in a zombie apocalypse, the world has gone to shit, and you're playing as Joel Miller. Joel still has nightmares about 20 years ago when this all happened, and his daughter died. You mainly play as Joel. He is set as basically your main character. I say this because you also play as someone else later on, and this is as Ellie. So yeah, let me just get started. So you wake up 20 years later, after everything went to shit and you lost your daughter, to a woman named Tess knocking at your door. Basically, she's going after a guy named Robert, or well, both of you are. Basically, he just sold your guns to someone else. And he tried to get you killed. So anyway, you guys gear up, go after him, kill him. Because he just, I mean, he's a dumbass. Honestly, he's a real big shithead. And you are now looking for Fireflies, which basically is a rebellious group. They're not really set with the rules of how everything is going. Because the country basically is now divided in states. So you have military states, basically. Military, outposts, you know, yeah, districts, I guess. I don't really know how to call them, but you're basically set in a military camp, and that's where you live. But the Fireflies don't really agree with that, so they are rebellious. So they set things on fire, they create disturbance, stuff like that. Anyway, Queen Firefly Marlene comes around the corner looking for Robert as well, and as he is laying dead on the floor, you, Tess, and Marlene basically kind of sort of make a deal. She promises you to get you your guns back if you smuggle something out of the city. Now, at first, they're really, you know, thinking about ration cards, stuff like that, because that's really important. But it's not about that. It's about a girl named Ellie. It's not really revealed on why she is being smuggled, but it's a 14-year-old girl. And she has some guts. Yeah, she's pretty brave. Anyway, this really... It's fast revealed that Ellie is immune to the infection. She was bitten 2 weeks ago, and she has not turned yet. So basically, you're kind of smuggling an infected girl, but that is immune. She has the bite mark, but, you know, she didn't turn. So story short, basically, that's kind of what the story is like. You meet a lot of, well, different characters. You meet Bill, for example. Bill is a really socially awkward, really mad, short-fused guy, I guess. He doesn't really like you, but he does help you later on. You also meet Henry and Sam, who are basically fleeing from some bandits in an armored Humvee. Story is pretty big, but like I said, I assume you guys know about it by now. The game has been out since 2013, so I don't really want to go too much into the story, but it's a really emotional story. And I'm not gonna lie, I cried real fast in the beginning when you basically play as Joel when he loses his daughter. And it's just an emotional story. It's a really good story. And for those who haven't played it yet, I really recommend playing it. I know this is maybe a little bit short, but like honestly, the game has been out since 2013, and most people already seen the gameplay, seen the game, you know, played the game even. And I just feel like most of you know it by now. But anyway, you are smuggling Elite Towers, Fireflies, and everything goes wrong. I mean, you're doing this with a woman named Tess. Tess dies pretty early on in the Capitol building after she has been bitten and sacrifices herself almost. Joel doesn't really believe that Ellie is immune until she breathes in spores, which basically are meant to turn people into infected or even, you know, even kill them. Just kill them. It's just, you know, this it's a whole journey. And eventually you meet up with the Fireflies and it is revealed that after some talk, you know, Ellie and Joel have this ball now, and yeah, it's just Joel kind of doesn't want to lose her, and that is exactly what's gonna happen, because they arrive at the hospital. Celeste stop, And Marlene, I don't know how she beat us to it, but she is there already. And she basically reveals that whatever makes her immune is over the brain, so she will die from it. And Joel, it doesn't sit right with him. And he decides that that's not gonna happen. And he well he kidnaps her, basically from the hospital. It's like a big story. You even meet up with Tommy later on. It's just honestly, I recommend really playing this because it's so much to talk about. But I don't want to spoil everything for you guys because it's just a lot. You know, the story is really beautiful. But I am gonna talk about the infected. I'm gonna be talking about the weapons that you get because there's a lot. And I will be talking, of course, about my actual review of like the game. So let's start about the infected, alright? So you have four stages of infected in this game. You have the runners, which are basically the freshest of infected. They are really fast. They are really, well, harsh. They're really like action filled. They run at you. They scream, run at you. They start hitting you like crazy. This is basically the first stage of infected, and they're really easy to like recognize because they make sounds. They like sort of cry, hum, like oh, something like that. It's they're really easy to defeat as well, honestly. It's just the earliest stage. Then the second is the Stalker, which has it's basically what you think it is. This infected type has mushrooms all over them already, a little bit, not too much, but a little bit. These are my most favorite, or my least favorite infected because they, well, like I said, they do what you think. They basically attack you at first and then they hide and watch you from a distance. Even with hearing mode, sometimes you don't hear them. Which makes them basically stalkers, which I think that's how they got the name. Like I said, these are my least favorite because they hit you, they run away, and that's it. And then they keep hitting you, and that's gonna. It's annoying. Luckily, you don't really face these often. Runners, you see a lot more often, but stalkers, you only see like twice, I think, in this game. But I need to admit, every single time that I encounter them for the first time, it scares the shit out of me. So yeah, they're not fun. They're not fun at all. Then the third stage is a clicker. You see a clicker really fast into the game. Basically, as soon as you smuggle Ellie out of the city, you go through a building and it is filled with clickers. That's the first encounter you get with them. They're not really a lot in the game, but when they are in the game, it's really annoying. You have a few scenes, for example, where you just, you know, you have to defeat a clicker. Like one of them is when you are hanging upside down. It sounds really crazy, but like in Bill's Town, he has a lot of traps, and one of them hangs you upside down. And this is basically a scene where you have to shoot upside down while Ellie is cutting you down. And there's a few clickers coming at you, and it's really irritating. They did that really well, though. So basically, clickers. There are the third stage. They have fungal basically everywhere. But they are completely blind, so you can flash them in the eye and they won't see it. They basically use signals like bats do. Like the more sounds you make, the more they know where you are. They're pretty smart, honestly. They're blind, but they're smart. And then you have the last stage, and that's the most, I don't know, horrendous, this destruction-based effect that they have in the game, and that is a bloater. You only see the bloater twice, and I totally understand why, because it eats, and it just eats and swallows all your ammo like it's nothing. Bloaters are filled with fungus. They're basically a giant fungus ball. They have been infected the longest, basically, I would say years of infection, basically. They throw spores at you, which hurts you over time, of course. The longer you stay in it, the more it hurts. Like I said, though, they eat all your bullets. I think the first time you encounter a bloater is right in Bill's Town as well, when you try to escape through the school. And it just, I mean, I think I left this. Okay, I joined the school with basically like half a mag, and I ended the school with like maybe only a pipe left. They eat bullets. It's really crazy. And with most of these infected, you can just, you know, hit them with a bat or pipe, like you find that. With bloaters, you just cannot. If you come close to this bloater, he just literally deflects your attack and he rips you literally apart. It's pretty gruesome, I'm not gonna lie. With clickers, this is kind of the same thing. With clickers, you really have to have luck. If you are on like one bar of the pipe, then you're not gonna beat that clicker with it. But if you have a shiv, which we'll get later on, you can basically just stab them in the neck. Unlike real zombies, the infected can be defeated without headshots. So basically, you don't have to destroy the brain. Eventually, they will just die, which is kind of good, you know. So that's basically infected. However, there is more to it. I mean, like I said, I will also be talking about the guns. So the first gun you have is the 1911. At least it looks like it. It's just called a pistol. Later on, pretty fast after you, like in the building where you first meet the clicker, you get a revolver. That's your secondary pistol, and you can upgrade these on workbenches. So like, you know, it's for clip capacity, fire rate, everything, you can upgrade them. You have to have scrap metal for it though, but you will find that pretty solidly. So that's the two pistols you start off with, and then later on you get a hunting rifle in the museum where Tess basically dies. It has a one round clip basically, but like I said, you can upgrade that to three clips with a scope. Put a scope on it, make it good. It's honestly a really good sniper. Then you get a shotgun when you meet Bill. Oh, and a bow before you meet Bill, even. You get a bow and arrow. Or compound bow, I guess it's called. Which is, of course, one of my favorite weapons, but in this game, it kind of sucks. It is. The arrows are basically like a two-shot kill with most infected, unless it's a headshot. Usually, that's a one-hit kill. Sometimes it doesn't really necessarily work the way you want. Like I said, though, then after that you get a shotgun. Well, pretty much just a shotgun, you know it. And then later on you get a flamethrower. Yes, you get a flamethrower. And then the last weapon is an assault rifle. That is when you are basically rescuing Ellie out of the hospital, or well, more or less kidnapping her. And I think that's all the guns really. But you also have a few other weapons, and that one of them is a Molotov. Which, well, is basically what you think of it. It's alcohol and flame. You throw it and they set on fire. Really, really good for infected, especially clickers and bloaters. They hate fire. I mean, I would hate it too if I was set on fire, but either way, they hate it, and it is one of the most effective things out there. Second is a nail bomb, which you get from Bill. Like I said, Bill has booby-trapped his town. He literally has a whole town. He has booby traps on this, and this is what you are getting his nail bombs. You can put the nail bombs down with R2, but you can also throw it at them. Usually, that kind of lures the infected or even people, tower shit, to check it out because it kind of has this brick glass mechanism where you can draw them to you. The bomb is basically just like that, only it explodes. It is usually just a one-hit kill, and that is really good, except for bloaters. Bloaters are just like massive tanks, bro. You can't kill them with one thing. And then you have also the smoke bombs, which, well, basically blinds the enemy. It kind of stuns them. Really easy, really nice. Usually it really lasts not that long. You can upgrade them though. You find manuals throughout the game that upgrade your shit. But yeah, honestly, they're one of my favorites alongside some other stuff. Oh, and one pistol, I totally forgot, I just realized. You get one more pistol, and that's the El Diablo. This pistol is basically kind of like a revolver almost, but it has a massive scope on it, and it is like it's a beast. I love it. But anyway, back to the items. I totally forgot about the pistol. I always forget about the pistol because you get it really late on. And of course, you have your med kit, your glass, or your brick. You can only hold one glass and one brick at a time. I always choose for the glass. I don't know why, but I just like the sound of glass smashing to their face. You can, like I said, you can distract enemies with glass or bricks, just like a pipe bomb. But you can also literally throw it at them, quick throw it at them, and it will stun them, and it lets you basically melee them. Really effective. Highly recommended. It's a lot of fun to use that. Of course, like I said, medkit, you will need those for sure. So yeah, that's kind of the weapons, kind of the infected. So yeah, let's hop on the next segment, and that is your pros and the cons. One big pro I have for this game is that it's a beautiful game. The story is really good. I might be biased though. This is really an opinion of someone who has played like 8 times throughout this game. It adds the story-based aspect and mixes it with horror elements. You have a lot of jump scares in this game. You have moments that you really feel terrified, especially when you play as Ellie. I didn't really explain this, but you play as Ellie at one point because Joel gets hurt. And basically, Ellie's out hunting and she meets this guy who is really friendly, but turns out to be not only a cannibal, but also really a really creepy guy. Without going too much into it, he wants to do stuff to her, let's just say that. And I mean, that's one of the moments I was really terrified in the game and like when I first played this, because it is such a scary segment. Because you have to basically escape this guy because he kidnaps you. And before he can chop you, before he can literally eat you, you tell him, you're infected. And Ellie runs. And at the same time, you have Joel coming for Ellie, who is now, being hunted by this David and his man. The man basically that Joel killed before. And you eventually are being chased into a diner and David locks it up and he just chases you around with a machete. And every single time you walk over a plate, because there's a lot of plates scattered through the diner, he will hear it and he will come for you. And you have to be so sneaky, so quietly, and it's really terrifying because one wrong move and you're done for. And I think that is when I was really scared, and Ellie really gets traumatized because of that as well. Later on in the game, she basically doesn't really pay attention to Joel for a few minutes. Well, I mean, a few days probably in their time, but she's really distracted. She's still thinking about that, and I mean, I understand. But anyway, that's one of those segments that I really enjoyed because also with the hanging upside down in Bill's Town, it's creepy because you can't really do much. And in a situation like this, I imagine people, well, maybe not the traps, but I imagine people being really creepy, being cannibalistic. I wouldn't really be surprised. I mean, people are freaky people. That makes sense, okay? Let's just say that. Anyway, it is really nice to have that horror element because I'm not really a big horror fan. I try to kind of evade them. I evade horror games and horror movies, shows even. And when I placed, I first watched this and then I played it, and it's so much better because there is a story to it that is so enjoyable and it's not all the time horror, which I think is really nice. But the story is beautiful, or the graphics are beautiful, and the characters really drag you in because I felt really bad when Tess died, for example. Big spoiler, sorry if you haven't seen it yet, but anyway, Tess dies really early on, and I felt so sad for her. Same with Sarah, when you begin the game, she dies. It was such a sad moment, and I felt really bad for Joel. And there's a few scenes that actually almost made me cry. There's a scene that made me cry. Like, you're so emotional invested in these characters, and that is such a good thing. They did that really great. But there is a few cons, so let me hop over on that. So one of the main cons that I have is that the AI can be a little bit buggy. So when I was playing this for recording, I didn't really talk through it. I just recorded the cutscenes mainly for you guys, which you will by now, see in the background. But when I was playing, one of the sections you have a few bandits that you need to defeat. And one guy literally just glitched through the floor. I mean, I need to admit, I didn't see that one before. It was kind of weird. But on the same side, I'm kind of like, okay. But honestly, then again, the AI is a little bit buggy because sometimes when you are playing a Joel, Ellie doesn't let you go through the door, and only after like a minute of trying to walk through her, she will go aside. And the same with can be said for bandits attacking you, for infected attacking you. I had infected and bandits just kind of teleport almost, and I had Joel teleport towers and infected when you hit R2 to hit someone, and he just literally zooms over to them and just just hits them, and I mean, it works out, but it's crazy how bad that can be sometimes. Not that it is game breaking, like some games we know out there, it can be really game breaking with glitches. This is just more annoying, and I think that is mainly the biggest con that I have, is that sometimes AI can be a little bit annoying. As in not like bad, like too strong, but like literally as in teleporting, as in nearly evaporating into the ground. I mean, that was a little weird, I'm not gonna lie. Now, one other con that I have is maybe not necessarily a con, but they leave you with an open ending. And I know that sounds really weird, but basically after Joel rescues Ellie in from the hospital, well, like I said though, he kidnaps her basically because Ellie wanted this. But anyway, he, you know, they go over to Tommy again because they decided to go there to live there, and Ellie makes him swear that everything he said about the Fireflies is true. He basically told her a big ass lie that there is a bunch of immune people, and that basically it's not working. And he promises her that, and she just kind of looks at him like faithfully, like, okay. But this is a big ass lie, and this is a big ass risk because while the game is beautiful and it has a great story, you never know how the game is gonna go. I feel like if this game was a huge ass flop, we would have been left with a sort of semi-open ending because you can see that Ellie is not entirely sure that he's telling the truth. And I mean, it's a big risk. Not gonna lie. Now, that is mainly more a thinking ahead kind of thing, because I wouldn't say like necessarily it's a really bad thing, but it is something to think about, because if this game was bad, then honestly this probably wouldn't have had a sequel. And it I mean it does, so we're good, but imagine, you know, imagine. So that's basically the cons I have. Now, there is one more thing that I want to talk about, and that is the DLC, which is called Left Behind. I wanted to add this into this review because Left Behind is basically kind of an extended little verse of The Last of Us. Left Behind follows Ellie 2 weeks basically before she gets bitten. Or well, maybe 3 weeks, I don't know. Anyway, her friend Riley comes back into town and they kind of fool around, they kind of, you know, and have fun. Eventually, Riley reveals that she will be joining their Fireflies, and she asks basically Ellie to come with her. Anyway, Ellie is not really sure. A lot happens in that time, you know. Ellie kind of likes Riley apparently. They kiss, and then they are being chased by a horde. So basically, this is a really short DLC, but it kind of switches in between this story of Ellie and Riley and as Ellie on her own. So this is gonna sound weird, but Ellie, on her own is basically in the meantime that Joel is wounded. So in the meantime that is the in-between part of Joel getting hurt and Ellie, being chased by bandits. That's basically in between. So you find out that Ellie has to recover medicines, stuff like that, and this follows Ellie's little, you know, journey on that, and it follows Riley and Ellie. And you'll see how basically Ellie is still thinking about that. It's kind of like in her head, I feel like almost that she's just thinking about it. But anyway, like I said, Riley and Ellie get chased by a horde and they both get bit. And Riley says to her, "Let's just be poetic and lose our minds together." She says this in the main game as well in the end, that she's still waiting for her turn. But this was basically Riley saying it to her, and Riley turned and Ellie didn't. And it really makes you think, like, Ellie has been through a lot. She lost a lot of people. First Riley, then she lost Tess, which she actually kind of liked, I guess. Sam, which she was friends with, but I mean, he got bit. He turned, and Henry shot himself. And then, you know, it focuses so much on her story. I mean, she is 14 years old. She was born in this apocalypse. I mean, okay, let's be real here though. Who thinks about that kind of stuff? Don't you have bigger things to deal with? But anyway, so it really focuses on her story, and I think that's a really good addition. I wanted to add this into this review though, because when you play the game on PS4, it is actually in, it is basically in the game. You have it for free, And it is such a good DLC, and it cannot be go to waste. But to make a review solely for that DLC is just a little bit too much. I had fun playing Last of Us for sure. I have fun playing Left Behind. I don't even know if I finished Left Behind though. Now I think of it. But anyway, I would rate this game basically probably an 8.5. Like I said, there is glitches in this game. There's bugs. They're not game breaking, but they're just plain annoying. And eventually, like sometimes it's okay, but like each gameplay that I had on this game, it had some sort of glitch. Like it had maybe teleportation, or it had Ellie getting in your way. But like the most recent one I played, literally had everything. It was 10 out of 10 on that one, yeah. No, but if it didn't have those bugs, if the AI was a little bit better, like it's not bad, but a little bit better, I would say a 9, because this game it's pretty flawless. But there is certain things that I
You can
just feel like
still
maybe could
do
have
the
been
right
better,
thing
could have been
here.
done better. But
She won't feel
mainly the open
anything.
ending, for example. I mean, it's not necessarily an open ending, but you can see it as one, and I do kind of see it as one. I also wish you some more of Bill. You basically don't really see a lot of Bill. Maybe even have a DLC from him, you know? Like, I would have not mind seeing how Bill basically got this town and just kinda set up traps. Honestly, I wouldn't have mind, but you know, they decided not to do that, and that's okay. But like I said, I would rate it an 8.5. I know that's maybe a little low for a lot of
How am I
people, but
wearing?
I
Stay at
mean,
ease.
like I said, the
Truck, you're still
glitches,
wearing
the
all
open
that.
ending, it kinda makes the score drop a bit, because
What
you know
happened?
it could have been really good, could have been flawless, and I know that critics are probably like 10 out of 10, 10 out of 10,
Found fireflies.
but it's just not a 10. And if it was a 10, there wouldn't be any bugs, there wouldn't be any AI
Turns out there's a
flaws, you know.
whole
There
lot
is
more
games out
like
there
you,
that
Ellie.
have that, and I would rate
People
maybe
that are
even better,
mean,
but
dozens
this game
actually.
is certainly not bad. If you
You
have a
done a damn
PS3,
better game than
PS4,
me.
I would suggest getting this game if you
You've
haven't
actually
yet. Play it for yourself. I didn't want to include
You've
any
stopped looking
spoilers
for
or
it, Jerry.
anything because, like I said, this game has been out since 2013. It was one of the more frequent, more
I'm taking
first,
this home.
more first. Either way, it was one of the first PlayStation 4 exclusives. Well, actually,
Sorry.
that's not true. PlayStation 3 and 4. And when I got this on PlayStation, I had to play it for myself. And it's just beautiful. It's a beautiful game, and it's set in a really good environment. The story is really interesting because, you know, it's not just another zombie game. It's not even necessarily a zombie game. It's literally just, they're not necessarily zombies. They're just infected,
Wait.
who've gone absolutely wild. The
Let me
people
go.
that have lost their minds. With just mushroom-looking heads sometimes. But anyway. Yeah, that was a review for Last of Us. I know it's a really short one, but like I said, I figure a lot of people have seen this game already, have played this game already, and I mean, if you don't know the story by now, I'm sorry, I'm not really gonna spoil everything for you, but I did spoil a little bit of things for those who haven't seen it yet, or haven't played it yet, and yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed, regardless. Hope you guys liked the cutscene in the background. I didn't really necessarily know what to do with it, but. Yeah, we'll see. Anyway, thanks for watching. Really appreciate it. Have a nice night, nice day, nice night, wherever you are. And I'll see you guys in the next reveal video, which will be on Thursday or Friday, one of the 2 days. And it will be The Last of Us 2, because why not? Let's finish this game series for now. And yeah, The Last of Us 2 is a really interesting game, and I can't wait to review it. So yeah, hope to see you guys in the next one. Bye guys. Love you.
Swear to me that everything that you've said about the Fireflies is true.
I swear.
Okay.
Baby, this is do or die. Feel it in my veins tonight. Emotional suicide. You know it's a knife.